My name is Daniel, and today I'm gonna show you the step of CDI. Okay, let's go.
In electronic, a current divider is a simple linear circuit that produces an output current IX that is a fraction of input current I total IT. Current division refers to the splitting of current between the branch of the divider.
And now I'm gonna show you the circuit that I want to explain to you the current divider rules works. Okay. This is the what is called it. This is called impedance circuit. Impedance current source. So it has this airflow. Current flow. This current flow is go to up, and another one is go to down. So if the current flow is going to down, it's going to the ground. If its current is going to up, it will go to another circuit. Okay, right now, the I total is the independent current source that is main over here. So the current flow will flow over here because the current flow is going to up. So it's going to the circuit flow, and until it find this knot. So this knot is currently dividing two currents. So which mean this one is will be let's say I1. Okay, and next this gonna be, I'm gonna say that is I2, or I2 is equals to IX. So this main over here, IX, we're gonna find this IX. So IX is equal to I2.
Years later.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Ari Ashraf bin Kifli. Today, my team and I will introduce about CDR formula. Before that, I will continue the explanation from my teammates Daniel about the IX and give you the example of formula CDR.
Okay guys, to find IX, by using CDR formula, we must use CDR formula to create from this to this. From this figure, this is R1, R2 and R3. These three must be parallel to each other like this. R3 parallel with R2 and parallel with R1. Then we will get the new circuit like this. And we assume this as RY. Okay, this will be IX, this will be RX, and this will be our new RY. To find IX from this figure, you must first using CDR formula. The CDR formula, if you want to find the current from RX, you must using the opposite resistor that is RY. For example, if you want to find IX, you must find this opposite resistor that is RY divide by RX plus RY times with I total. That for IX. And if you want to find the current from RY, the formula is vice versa. For example, we want to find this IY, so So the opposite resistor is Rx. Let me show it to you. Iy equals to Rx over Rx plus Ry times I total.
Hello and greeting, I bid to all the viewers. I am Malcolm Liming Franklin and welcome to the next section of the video in which we will discuss and apply the formula of current divider rules and try it out on an easy question and see how it goes. So grab your pen, grab your calculator and a piece of paper and put on your thinking caps and let's go. Paper, calculator, pen. Let's go. So let's say we have two resistors in parallel. We give it our source, and this first resistor we call it R1. This one we call it R2 for reference. And the current that flows through this circuit is 6 amps. So the value of R1, let's say we'll give it 4 ohms, and for R2 we'll give it, let's say, 8 ohms. So the question wants us to calculate the current that flows across resistor 1 or R1. So we know that the voltage across the parallel resistors will be constant. From here to here will be constant to this one. The relationship between resistance and current is inversely proportional, meaning to say when the resistance is high or increases, the current decreases. So the formula to calculate the current in the branch is I1 equals to I total times the opposite, which now we are calculating R1, so the opposite is R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So take your calculator. I total is 6 amperes, R2 is 8 ohms, R1 is 4 ohms, plus R2 8 ohms. 8 divided by 4 plus 8 is times 6 amperes, equals to 4 amperes. So 4 amperes is the current that flows through R1. To calculate the current that flows to R2, we take I2 is equals to I total times the opposite resistor, which is R1, R1 divided by R1 plus R2, inversely from the previous formula, equals to I total is 6 amperes, 6, R1 is 4, divided by R1 plus R2, 4 plus 8. 4 divided by 4 plus 8 times 6, F2.
Look, up in the sky, it's a bird!
It's a plane!
It's Super
Kent!
Yes, it's Superman!
Hi, my name is Lee Kent, and now let's proceed to the more complicated question. Let's go.
This is an electric circuit which contains a lot of resistor and a voltage supply, which is 15 ohm. And each resistor in it is 1 ohm. So first of all, we need to find the total resistance, because there is no the I total. We cannot find it. The I total is here. So we need to find the total resistance cover up with using Ohm's law. And we can find the I total, and then we can proceed to another step to find the current passes through R9 here. First of all, we need to know that R series is equal to RA plus RB plus RC and so on. R parallel is equal to RA times RB times RC over RA plus RB plus RC. A series circuit here. A series circuit here and a series circuit here. We call this as RA. This as RB and then one up is RC. Let's find RA first. RA, as we can see, from using this formula, there's 5 resistor here, so 5 ohms. RB, 2 resistor here, RB is equal to 2 ohms. And RC, 2 resistor here, so RC is equal to 2 ohms too. After that, we need to parallel this circuit. So RA parallel with RB. From using this formula, RA times RB over RA plus RB. So it's 5 times 2 over 5 plus 2. And the answer is 1.429 ohm. We combine this and this circuit. This is a series circuit. So this circuit we can series up with the RC. RA parallel RB plus RC, which is 1.429 plus 2, sorry, equals to 3.429 ohm. This is the total resistance until here. Resistance over here, and we need to parallel with it, with the R9 and series it, and we can find the total resistance. RC parallel with the R9. RC is 3.429 multiplied with 3.429 plus 1. So the answer is 0.774 ohms until here, and the R total is R1 plus RC parallel with R9. So 1 plus 0.774 ohms equals to 1.774 ohms. This is a total resistance in the circuit. After that, we need to find the total current using Ohm's law. V equal to IR and I equals to V over R. The V is 15 volts, and the resistance here is 1.774 ohms. So I total is equal to 8.455 amperes. So, proceed to the question given. We need to find the current passes through R9 using the current divider rules as taught by my friend. R9 is equal to RC over R9 plus RC times with the total current. So it's 3.429, 1 plus 3.429 times with the total current 8.455, and we can give the final answer, which is 6.546 ampere. Hope you guys understand. Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Yeah!
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 Hey. And see how it goes. So grab your pen, grab your calculator and pen and paper to try it out on a piece of question.
Beforehand, I will continue the experiment about the IX and the and oi, sabar. Before that, I will continue. Sabar.